Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and tonight we're going to play Tyrannosaurs Meet the Family. This is a free-to-play game available on the iOS store produced by the Australian Museum. And you can even play it in Chinese, if you so choose. I do not. So we're going to play it in, Australian, by the looks of it. And basically, the idea behind this game is we're going to control a little dinosaur, we're going to smash some stuff up, and we're going to try to find these fossils. When we find these fossils, they're going to give us clues as to what the dinosaur actually is. It's like a little mystery game where you try to figure out what the Tyrannosaur is before you get all of the clues. So feel free to play along at home. I have had a couple of goes, so I kind of know how the game functions. It's a little bit messy, but the dinosaur models themselves are exceptionally well done. They're really, really good. So we're going to get started. So what we have to do is pick an egg now. We're just going to start in the top left, one I've never done before. This little egg here. So, what do we have to do with our mystery dinosaur? We have to hatch our dinosaur egg by tapping it or smashing it, then explore the enclosure for dinosaur fossils. We have to feed the fossil by providing it a clue. Nope. We have to feed the dinosaur fossils in order to provide a clue. And then once all three fossils have been found, we will get told some information about the dinosaur. You know, it's an educational kind of game. And we'll get the dinosaur name revealed. So, little Mr. Egg. Come on, little one. Push! Push! Very good. You ready, folks? Our first dinosaur. Let's see if anyone can get it just from the model. Poof! It's a dinosaur! It's a very small dinosaur. Interestingly enough, because a lot of people who are playing this game will have inevitably thought that tyrannosaurs are all humongous, you know? But you can totally understand why people would think that. So basically, my little dinosaur is going to run around and explore this little area. I'm going to tap that. And our goal is basically to smash some boxes and hopefully dig some fossils out. Yep. It took me a long time, I'm not going to lie, to figure out this is what you had to do. The game doesn't actually explain it at any point. It kind of took a little bit of effort for me to get here. But now we're here. Woo! All I'm doing is smashing crates. Now, have we unveiled any fossils? Doesn't look like it, does it? I think they're all hiding away a little bit. You really have to, you know, get quite a lot of oomph behind your throw. Otherwise they just don't smash. I'm struggling a little bit here. There's little bits of steak and stuff. We can feed our little dinosaur if we wanted to. If I put this here, pick up our dino, zoom in. He should go for it. Come on, little one. Come on, little one. Ram. Ram. Come on. Come on. Look. Delicious. Look, it's a T-bone. It's a delicious T-bone. You're a stupid dinosaur. Woo. Okay. Right, I haven't found any fossils yet, so. Aha! There is our first one right there. You can see we've got a big old, what looks like a femur or something. So, what is meant to happen, as far as I can tell, is that you tap on the fossil. I'm going to bring it up. I'm going to bring the dinosaur up. I'm going to bring the fossil up. Just onto straight land. Now, I don't know, by the way, why this takes place in an abandoned swimming pool in the middle of the city. You hear sirens and stuff in the background. It's a little bizarre. But oh, now you eat it, don't you? Come on, go for the fossil. Go for the fossil. Go on. Go on. Go on. Who's a good dinosaur? I have a nasal crest like others in my close family do. I also have three fingers on each hand and I'm pretty small for a tyrannosaur. Well, we can see that, can't we? Bloody tiny. Right, let's have a little look. Oof, nope. Ha, there's a big one. I think there's one. Oh. And there's the other one. There's the final two. He went straight for it. I may be considered primitive, but at least I'm not late. In fact, I'm one of the earliest. And the final fossil is over here. I think he's... Oh, I'm sorry. I just chucked it away from you. Go on. Come on, little. Come on. Guanlong is one of my closest relatives, and we both come from Central Asia. So, when I click this X button now, the game is going to reveal the name of this Tyrannosaur. So, ladies and gentlemen, those of you in the world who consider yourselves good at this kind of thing, your goal now is to try to guess exactly what this little Tyrannosaur actually is. Personally, I don't have a bloody clue. I'm going to be terrible at this, I promise you, absolutely terrible. But I'm going to give you guys a couple more seconds to guess. Do, 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 and we're going to hit the X button. It is Hit the X button again. It is Kelescus Aristotocus. Now, I have personally never heard of this thing, so this is really cool. We get to learn about new dinosaurs. Meaning of name, Kelescus means lizard in Kakas, a Turkish language from Siberia, and Aristotocus, Greek, means of noble origin. Details, 3 meters long, from the Middle Jurassic, 168 million years ago, first discovered in the early 2000s in Siberia, Russia, and wasn't named until 2010. So let's read a little bit about Kelescus. Kelescus is one of the oldest tyrannosaurs found so far, and the only one known from Siberia. Fossil material includes upper and lower jaw fragments and possibly associated hand and foot bones. Like others in its family, Proceratosauridae, it probably had enlarged nostrils. Can I just say I'm very proud of how I just handled that, no problem. A nasal crest and long arms with 3 fingers on each hand, its presence in Siberia supports the idea that Proceratosauridae originated in Asia. Because it's a very early version. Nope, adverts! Ah! There we go. A little dinosaur, and if we go back onto the main page, there we go, Kelescus, right there. And that is the premise of the game, but there are 1, 2, 3, right, so it's 3 in a row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 21, 22 dinosaurs in total, 22 different tyrannosaurs, specifically, somewhere, well, in this list. I think that's awesome, it's really cool for a free game. So we're going to go ahead and pick another. I have done 2 of them. So we're going to leave those ones for a little bit. I've done the second one, so I know what that is. And I've done this little dark red one at the bottom right. We're going to go for... Okay. Out of these 9 on the screen here. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Catch a tyrannosaur by its toe. If it hollers, let it go. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. We're going for this one. Don't know what that one was, do you? The bottom left one, I should say. Right. Are you ready? Get your guessing hats on. Your paleontology brushes out. Your... cats out of the dryer. I don't... Whatever. Tap. Come on, little one. Push. I am going to do that every single time. Push. Very good. Push. Well, you are not the same as last time. You're quite small, though, aren't you? Right there, our first skeleton. Awesome. And some teddy bears. I'm never going to understand why this is in the middle of an abandoned part of the city. I really won't. Come on, you. I'm going to grab that for you. There you go. You can do that in your own time. He's going for it. He's going for it. I'm just another middle of the pack tyrannosaur, although technically he's early Cretaceous. Early Cretaceous. Let's remember these factoids. It's hard work, this, folks. I'm not even joking. The boxes do not want to get smashed. And that little bit there, that little claw, is incredibly hard to spot. Sneaky little devil, there you go. Come on. He's going for it. I'm still waiting to be placed into my own family. Sigh. I'm sure T-Rexes, or, well, Tyrannosaurs sighed a lot. My branch of the tree separated from other Tyrannosaurids at the start of the Cretaceous. Okay, we're looking for one more. Oh my god, these actually explode. What am I looking for? I'm looking for, like, that femur-type bone, aren't I? Ah, there it is, hiding away in the corner, you cheeky little lemon. Come here. Thank you. Up the hill. Now, he's going to go have a little bit of steak first, which is fair enough. I'm not here to judge. Maybe eat a teddy bear if he's in the mood, but nope, there we go. I like to think of myself as a link between small-bodied tyrannosaurs and larger, later ones. I also have a long, narrow snout rather than the T-Rex's deep, massive one. Ladies and gentlemen, those are your clues. Guess time is over. What dinosaur is it? Put your answers down below. Guess and boop. It's a Zhongguanglong. Zhongguanglong. Baymoensis. We're going to learn so many new dinosaurs. I'm so excited. Zhongguanglong means dragon from Zhongguan in Mandarin. Many dinosaurs we've already dealt with have the same kind of name. The dragon we did a Pangaea today, like 2 years ago, actually, on a raptor from the same region. And Baymoensis is from the Mandarin for white ghost. Referring to the White Ghost Castle Rock Formation near that. That's an awesome name. Details, 45 metres long, a little longer than the last one, 113 to 100 million years ago in the early Cretaceous, first discovered in the mid-2000s in Gansu in western China and named in 2010. About me. It's like an online dating profile. Mid-sized and with a long, narrow snout, just like the ladies like it, similar to that of Alioramus Zhongguanlong. I've got to assume that's about approximately correct. I'm going to call him Guani, okay? It's one of the links between the earlier small-bodied tyrannosaurs and larger, later ones. Fossil material includes a complete skull, but no lower jaws, all neck and back vertebrae, a partial hip bone, and upper leg femur. Several hallmark features of late Cretaceous tyrannosaurs like T-Rex can be seen in the older Guani, such as boxy skull and midline crest at the back of the skull. Full-grown adults would have weighed about 270 kilograms. Compare this with the T-Rex Sioux, which may have weighed as much as 9 tons, otherwise known as over 8,000 kilograms. So you are like a little tiny one, aren't you? It's quite a cool-looking game. I can't skip it. Now I can. I can play that. Right, two done. Let's go for one from the middle. Which one do we like? Which one do we like? The blue one! Let's go for it. Come on, little one! Okay, can anyone guess what it is based on the colour of the egg? Because it is important, oddly enough. Then again, it completely depends just what colour they decide to make the dinosaurs. So that's really a stupid question, so I'm just going to tap it. Come on! You're a little feathery son of a gun, aren't you? Cool. Right, zoom out and smash! Well, that's the first bit. It seems silly to me that you're not getting dinosaur to smash things. That's kind of what I assumed. Okay, so it's another middle of the pack dinosaur. Not an early tyrannosaurid, but not a late one either. I wonder if I can chuck a ball at it. Let's find out. Come here. Right, where's my little dinosaur? There it is. Eh. Eat ball! Tyrannosaur. Bumps, bumps, bumps. Okay, I don't think he's interested. Nope, not interested. Whatever. You really do have to, you know, whew. I'm going to start collecting the fossils and just put them on that little central bit, just so I know where they are. Okay, I think that's actually everything smashed. I think that little claw, that little tooth, is out there somewhere and I can't quite see it. Because every box has been smashed, so it has to be out here somewhere. But it's so... Ah, see, look at it! Can you guys see it right now? Hopefully you can. It's just there, hiding away. It's unbelievably cheeky. They really could have gone for something more easy to spot. Come on. Come on, little one. Over here. Feast upon your own bones. I may not be that big, tell me about it, but I can still bite. My skull is small compared to my later relatives, and I have a great crest. And a great chest. You're just an all-around cool little dinosaur, aren't you? Little feathery son of a gun. It's nice seeing all these small tyrannosaurs. I was the first tyrannosaur found with feathers. Ooh. Now, I actually always thought the first tyrannosaur with feathers was Euteranus, and clearly I'm wrong, so I don't know what this is. But do you lovely folks at home know what this is? Let's find out. Do. It's Dialong Paradoxus. Of course it is. Why would you not get that? Dialong. Oh, we did a thing on Dialong. I've definitely heard of Dialong. I remember reading Emperor Dragon. Maybe that's why we did it, because of the feathers. I definitely referenced it once before. I'm trying to remember when, but I can't. Dialong means Emperor Dragon. Why do all these Chinese dinosaurs have awesome names? In traditional Chinese, and Paradoxus Greek is because of the surprising discovery of feathers on a tyrannosaur. So, it was 1.6 to 2 meters long from 138-ish million years ago in the early Cretaceous, and the first fossil was discovered in 2004. Now, that's interesting. It's only 13 years ago, and it's already accepted amongst most of us, I think, that a lot of tyrannosaurs would have had feathers. Now, I know there's debate about whether T-Rex had feathers and stuff like that. I fall on the side that it did, but it is interesting to see that it was only 13 years ago. Before that, it was perfectly reasonable to assume that no tyrannosaur had feathers at all, and now we all kind of take it for granted. It's just interesting. fossil discovered and named in the same year as well, which is quite unlike it for paleontologists. Usually they like to take a good few years to decide some things. Dialong was a very small tyrannosaur with an unusual Y-shaped skull crest, two ridges running along its snout. Fossil material includes skull and skeletal material of at least four individuals. One of the first fossil specimens found of Dialong preserved a downy count of downy coat, bloody Nora, best of luck, of proto-feathers, the first ever found on a tyrannosaur. Although surprising, it was not completely unexpected, as numerous other coelurosaurs are known to have been feathered. Coelurosaurs. Dialong's proto-feathers were useless for flying, but well-suited for keeping the little predator warm. Dialong's skeleton, with its long skull, slender neck, long arms, and three-fingered hands, was in many ways more like those of other Coelurosaurs? God only knows. Than other Tyrannosaurs. However, its legs were short for a Tyrannosaur, suggesting Dialong was probably not a fast runner. And you can play fish them, if you like. I do not. Okay, we're going to do one of the ones I have done, just because we've done three little ones, and we know what this one is. Can anyone guess, before we click it, what the dark red one is going to be? You should. I recognised it instantly before finishing the clues. So let me do a thing. Come on, little one. Poof. What dinosaur is that, ladies and gentlemen? Should not be a problem for you folks. Looks really cool, though. Really impressed. Whee! I've always wanted to do this. I'm not going to spoil it, just in case somebody has not quite figured it out. But if I can figure it out without doing the clues, everyone else should be able to. Really? There's our skull. It's weird, right? I think if all the game was picking up the skulls, it would be rubbish. But I don't particularly love breaking all these myriad boxes for no apparent reason, so... Lucky last, I always say. So, the last Tyrannosaur, the last big Tyrannosaur. What was the last big Tyrannosaur, folks? What was it? Answers on a postcard. That little claw keeps, like, hiding away in the deepest, darkest recesses of the entire bloody map. I am the king. I wonder what that could possibly be signifying. And there's the bone. Oh, just wanted some meat, didn't you? You cheeky little so-and-so. Come on. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with being big-headed, and mine is the biggest. We're so alike. Ladies and gentlemen, what dinosaur is it? Do. That's right, it's a Tyrannosaurus Rex, obviously. Tyrannosaurus means tyrant lizard, and Rex means king. From 12 to 14 meters long, 68 to 66 million years ago, much more recent than pretty much every other Tyrannosaur we've been looking at by 40, 50, 60, 70 million years. First discovered in 1874 in the USA and Canada, and species was named in 1905. 31 years it took for it to be named. About me. T-Rex was the largest and most successful Tyrannosaur and the last of its kind. Although now bumped from its position as largest meat-eating dinosaur ever, thank you Spinosaurus, it's still up near the top. It's also one of the best studied Tyrannosaurs due to the number of specimens now found. Famous almost complete specimens include Sue and Scotty. T-Rex is famous for its very short arms. The reduced length of the arms may be due to the enlargement of the massive heads of Tyrannosaurids. Since an increase in head size relative to the body requires a decrease in arm size to retain balance, along with a counterbalancing tail, T-Rex is one of the most popular and enduring dinosaurs of all, starring in movies and kids shows, as well as featuring in pop culture memorabilia. And then we have to put up the advert for 4 seconds, there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the first four dinosaurs out of 22. So, if we did slightly longer episodes, let's say we did six dinosaurs per episode, that would be another three episodes if I can do basic mathematics, which I probably can't. I love that the eggs move as I do this. Whee! Look, if go down. Oh, they kind of... It's awesome. Anyways, it's an interesting little game. Whether we play no more is down to you lovely folks at home. If you enjoyed this and this kind of content, do let me know. Hit that like button if you want to see more, and I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. And don't forget to subscribe. And if you have subscribed, go do something for me, folks. Go down to the bottom where it says subscribe and make sure that little bell is ticked or rung or whatever it is. Otherwise, you may not get notifications for my content. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.